a boring, normal Saturday night for me. So I'd been in bed about, I think, an hour, hour and a half tops when I got a call from the office saying, you know, get in, Diana's been in an accident. The information we were getting from Paris was that she'd been injured in a non-threatening way, something like a broken collarbone or perhaps a broken leg. It went from some non-threatening injury to her being in intensive care was the information we got. I think at that point we twigged that something was very seriously wrong. We were also getting the information in about car chases and 100 mile an hour Mercedes and things like that. And putting those pieces together, I think forming in the back of my mind was, you know, was the impending enormity of what we were going to tell the nation.
We have a flash here from the Press Association Newswire saying that Diana, Princess of Wales, has died in a car crash in Paris. The French Interior Minister, Jean-Pierre Chevènement, has confirmed that the Princess of Wales is dead.
The hairs really do stand up on the back of your neck. A lump does form in your throat. I got a break in the morning, sent back home for a kind of shower and a shave, and my kids were just getting up, and my eldest daughter just, you know, said, "The princess is dead, isn't she?" And I said, yeah, it's, you know, it's very, very sad. I just gave her a bit of a hug and said, you know, it's okay, you know, it's fine.
Goodbye, England's rose. May you ever grow in our hearts. You were the grace that placed itself where lives were torn apart. You called out to our country, and you whispered to those in pain. Now you belong to heaven, and the stars spell out your name. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never fading with the sunset when the rain set in. And your footsteps will always fall here along England's greenest hills. Your candles burned out long before. Devil.